Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Ladies Night with Dr. J. And today is going to be a different class. A different one, never been seen before. So, welcome once again. And before I start to talk, I want to make sure that my audio is good. Okay. So if you can hear me clearly, please give me some thumbs up. Just say loud and clear in the comment section. Let me know and be sure that my audio is good. Give me loud and clear in the audio section so I know that my audio is perfect, okay? So if you can see me loud and clear, let me know. And before I start my talk tonight, I'm supposed to be on since 8 o'clock, but I had to quickly clear some information and messages in my WhatsApp from our troubled members in ATG. So that's why it took a while, about 10 minutes, I've been late or 50 minutes later to come up live. So if you can see me, say, yeah, thank you, Nwa, for Inke Dillum for sending that message that you can hear me loud and clear. So once we have about 100 people, I'm going to start. And tonight's session is going to be on for ladies' night. So if you're a guy, come and listen, okay? Today, so you can see me with this kind of what I don't know what I'll call this mask, whatever it is. So you can see me. So this is Dr. J again. I'm not different, I'm still the same guy. I'm now Dr. Zoro for tonight. Dr. Zoro. So let's start. I need to get you in the mood. I need to get you all in the mood, into the mood for action. Tonight, Friday, must be different, okay? Tonight, this Friday is going to be a different one, okay? And I ate darling, okay? Tonight, this Friday should be different. So if you are not ready, leave the class. This class is for adults only. So if you are at home, put on your hairpiece so that your kids at home will not hear things they're not supposed to hear. This is parental advisory. What I call it again? One ago, parental advisory. So if you are not 18 years old, you're younger than 18, Facebook post now and get out. Okay? This is for adults only. This is for what? Adults only. One ago, this is for what? Adults. If you are not yet an adult, work out. If you're an adult, you got kids around you, put on your hairpiece, okay? So that babies will not hear. There was an incident last week, somebody removed their hairpiece and the baby was hearing something. Tomato. They say, I was tomato, brown tomato. I don't want that kind of thing. I don't want to spoil anybody here, okay? I'm not spoiled too, but things I've been seeing, they are for adults only. Now, this is the church of ATG. If you are here, get ready and let's gather here to listen. You see, like I always say, I don't understand some ladies. I don't understand some ladies. And also, I don't understand some men. Let me talk to the men first. Trust me, a woman will follow you to anywhere. To any extent, in the bed, outside the bed, as far as she sees a man she can respect. If you put yourself and make yourself respectable to your wife at home, you're respectable, you do the things you're supposed to do, a woman will go with you to any length in the bedroom and will take for command from you and she will rotate her bum bum and keep on rotating. The anyhow, to anywhere, to any side triangle, any associate triangle, any roundabout, as far as you're giving her instruction, she will obey you. Women want their husband to be somebody they can respect. Okay? So, men, once you've done that part, don't worry about the woman. She will obey you. Any style you want, before you ask, she'll do it. You just flip your hand, say this, she'll do it. Women love to take instruction from you in the bedroom if you don't know that they love it too. And women also want you to undo them in the bedroom as if you got things under control. Women love men that have confidence. In fact, Life loves anybody that has confidence. Much more so, a woman will love a man that has confidence and that can give her control in bed. Women can change their ringing tone for you. That's why you see some women in the bedroom or in your house, you think they're dull. Every woman has got action. You just need to know what to dial and to press in the ringing tone for you to hear the harmonious sound she got. No woman is dull. Even the Yoruba lepa, they have action. And God has blessed the lepa women with something. They are very, very good in bed. And the Yoruba too, they have action. But it takes a man to understand how to take a woman to their height. And any man can get it. So men, first of all, have confidence. Believe that you got all it takes. That is for the men today. Now, for the women tonight, there's nothing any woman out there can do to your man if you do it already. Life abhors vacuum, okay? And life does not allow empty space. Women, I'm talking to you today directly. Next week, maybe by God's grace, God willing, God keep us till then, and even after then, I'll talk to the men. Today is for the women. There's nothing any woman out there can do for your man that you cannot do. All those times, all those girlfriends, all those slim mama that are giving your husband or your husband that they are cheating. So anything they are doing there, you can do it too. And you bring the man back to their senses and you reboot their brain. Whether it's all those style, mountain style, doggy style, snake in the monkey shadow, wheelbarrow, rotating, squeezing and releasing, reverse missionary, tumble top, wheelbarrow, anything you can do. Let me tell you, for you to be a better person in sex in the bedroom, you need to desire to have sex. I'm not talking about people that have pain during sex now. I'll go to that later. But today is to teach you the techniques to do. First of all, you have to be creative. You can see me wearing this mask, and there's a purpose for me wearing this mask today. Sometimes you want to see somebody new in the bedroom. You can't change your face. We can be creative. Why don't you go into the bedroom and wear something like this, lovely mask like this, or wear something, a total mask, and just look different to your husband. Look at that, look to him like with that sex macho woman, that sex hungry lady, and look different. Surprise him. Okay? You go into the bedroom, you're wearing pants, a dick. You are putting toll gate on Mark Zuckerberg Bridge. Why not? Why should you put toll gate? Didn't they tell you all this thing before you got married? Look different. Even if you don't have all this kind of mask, okay? You can do this thing. Let me tell you. And this is number one. Take your notes and lay and pay attention. Now, you get into the bedroom. It's been a while you've had sex. You're very familiar with your husband. He's familiar with you. He's used to you. Two of you are used to each other. There's nothing new. You have to spice up things. I told someone about 6 months ago that I was having a problem with her husband. You know, things are not working for them. They don't feel action. I told him, while in the bedroom, why don't you don't have a mask like this? Then use some wrapper, tie your face. Be vulnerable, release your body to the man. Tell the man to do anything and enjoy himself. It's your body. It's his body. Two of you are one now. So she thought that she took on the action. She tied her face. Totally. So she's oblivious to what's happening around her. She submits her husband, submits her body to her husband. And the husband enjoyed her body and she enjoyed herself too. Her sex life totally changed forever. Totally changed forever. Because she's covering her eyes. She's let her body go. She lets go. Once you let go and give yourself freedom, you give yourself freedom to enjoy what life has got and to even give your husband the time to enjoy himself too. There's no way, I tell people, there's no way your husband will give you sex that you enjoy, that you don't enjoy it. Action and reaction is equal and opposite. As above, so below. If you are enjoying the sex, your husband is enjoying it too. And you're shouting, don't stop, continue, don't stop, give it to me. Oh my God. Don't fake it. Minute. Okay? Minute. And if there's any particular area that you can hit and you can touch it. If you can't get this kind of mask like this, to me, you are wearing a mask for coronavirus. Take a wrapper that is old in your house, cut out a piece, tie it on your face like ninja now, and give him one too, tie it to like ninja now, And two of you, you have a different outlook. It's like you're seeing a new world with crystal eyes, and you are doing things you've not done before. If you are so perplexed, get a small bottle of a small shot, one shot of some whiskey. Take it to simmer your nerves and lie down there and submit your body to the altar of sex, to your husband, let him dissect the thing. Haven't you seen animals, they enjoy sex in the zoo? Haven't you seen animals, they enjoy sex in the prairie? Haven't you seen animals enjoy sex in the Sahara or in the savannah? I know we are higher than any animals, okay? Like I said last week, don't over spiritualize sex. Don't what over spiritualize sex. I'm not saying you should not pray before you have sex. If you want, that's fine. Okay? What I'm saying is, don't over spiritualize it. Okay? If you are tired of sex, sometimes some women, they are fed up of sex, sometimes after delivery, after a long childbirth, you can spice things up. Okay? You can use Gido if you have. Okay? Change your face. Go to the gym. Lose some baby fat. Okay? And start exploring styles you never explored before. Okay? As a woman, you can even learn to discover your body more after delivery, after having baby. Learn to finger areas of your vagina that is erotic and sensual for you. You can discover yourself. One of the areas in your body that is very sensitive as a woman is the entrance of your vulva. That's the vagina. You can touch your clitoris around your vagina to aim for that 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock position at the top of vagina. Those areas are very erotic, okay? And the most important thing that women love in men is not the length or the thing. Is the size, as in the diameter of the penis. If you're not endowed in that area as a man, then you can use other things too. There are things a man can use to pleasure a woman and take him to the eye. You see, the brain of a woman does not recognize size or this thing. What a woman's brain wants is the pleasure. So whatever you can do as a man to make the woman get to that pleasure zone, whether it's your mouth, whether it's your finger, whether it's your penis, whether it's your cucumber plantain, anything, you can, or whether it's dildo. Yes, I've seen some men use dildo on their wife. Whatever you can do to carry that woman to that pleasurable state, once she gets there, that is what she wants. She will come, she will release, attention will be free. I can tell you something. Number two, regular sex makes you live longer. Regular sex with the person you love, with the person you love, makes you live longer. After sex, don't you realize that after sex, you sleep better. Your sleep is much more sound. You snore, you relax. You wake up in the morning, you're ready to face the challenges of that new day with a renewed strength. Sex does that. Sex lowers your blood pressure. Sex makes you think and more confident. Okay? As a woman, if there are areas in your body that you want to mount your pleasure, let him know. Some women love to be in doggy position and want their man to stay over them as if the man is like a dog, like doggy. Not you kneel down behind you, as in stand with your two legs and be over and put your hand on the shoulder and you can go in maximum depth. If your woman is on the big side, that style works for everybody, whether big or small, whether leopard, tiny or rubber. That style works for everybody. If you got problem, maybe you're not endowed with the size or the strength of some people, size of penis, you don't have that big cucumber or cassava thing, you can still pleasure that woman by doing that style. The woman is lying down or kneeling down on all her fours and you stand on your two legs as if you are standing. Don't kneel down as a man. Stand with your two legs standing and then you have access to the whole Atlantic Ocean. You have access to the whole port. You have access to the whole altar. You have no restriction or visa to be taken into the whole toll gate. You enter Ogiri and there's straight express road, no toll gate anymore. You are flying 200 meters per hour, 200 kilometers per hour. It will give you maximum in-depth and you can penetrate and the woman can enjoy. You can't get it wrong. Trust me. If you haven't done it before, go do it today. Okay? And start enjoying the thing. And the woman will tell you, the woman will give you feedback and report. Don't stop, continue. That means that you are doing the right thing. Okay? It works. If you can don't even know what to do as a man. Do that style. Put on your ninja mask today, get old wrapper, cut out a piece, tie it round like you are in corona warfare. Put on your hat if you got a hat. Like me, I'm bald, so I always cover my head with hat. I look different. And you attack the thing like a cowboy. And you ride the thing like a cowman. Women too can do that too. Women too should learn to take control. As a woman, you should learn to control your pelvic floor muscles. Learn how to tighten it and release it. Tighten it. So sit down one day, take a deep breath like this, hold your pelvic floor muscles and tighten it and release it. So that when the man is entering in and out, as he's entering in, you squeeze the pelvic floor muscles and all the old vaginal wall is tightened around the penis of your husband. And you're feeling the old thing. It will register in your brain. It will imprint in your brain. And it will form a nerve path in your brain that will never be forgotten. So, as the man is entering, before he comes out, you squeeze your vaginal wall and vaginal muscle tightened around the whole girth of the penis. So for men that are on the small side, okay, a woman, okay, as a woman, you can make things better by learning how to squeeze the upper vaginal muscle round the penis so that your vaginal muscle will enjoy the whole thing. And by doing that, it will help to pleasure every area. Another thing too that can help men too that want to last longer in bed is to learn the half-length theory, okay? Half-length theory. If you want to last longer in bed, okay, sometimes you have to learn to improvise as a man. Don't go in fully. If you go in fully, you can empty the whole toothpaste in that thing. So you go in halfway, you come out. Don't go in fully. Just that tip of a penis, that tip, that corona of a penis, that not coronavirus, so we call it crown. See, the top of the penis is also called corona. It's the crown of penis, corona. The crown. Corona means crown because the virus, coronavirus, has a crown look. So we call it coronavirus. The same thing too with the penis too. The crown of the penis is called corona. You put it in, don't go into the full length of penis. Before you go in, come out again. Okay? Program yourself. Make it an habit. It will make you last longer. And the more you last longer, okay, one, and the more the woman can predict your in and out, that you're not going in and out completely. That is, there's a particular rhythm to your in and out. Wow. The woman will be programmed for climax. Learn it. Let that, see, as I go in and out as a man, let there be a measure, be consistent with your in and out. The speed, the right. Once in a while, you can go in fully to waken her up and to restart the engine once in a while. But, sorry, I think I'm going too much. Should I stop now? Someone is saying that I'm talking too much. Should I stop? This is for adult only. I say that you should go and ensure that all babies are asleep now and all children. So this is for adult only. Adult only. Okay. This is, I should continue. Should I stop? Let me see your... go. Okay. So I've been giving the audience to continue. So let your entry and exit as a man be predictable. Okay? Don't go in fully. Predictable. Do that about 40-50 times. See the action of your woman. That night, tonight, you hit something different. Tomorrow morning, you see a different woman. You awaken the whole power of Cleopatra in that woman today. So, no woman is dull. That woman has got action inside her. A Duracell battery that is ready to explode. You just need to find a key. And every lock has a key. Every key can fit a lock. Noisemakers. Somebody is taking names of noisemaker. And they're going to give me the names today. So, number one, change your face. Put a hat on, mask on, can tie your wrapper, do ninja look, half length, lion style, mountain. Don't bend down as a guy with your knee. Stand up with your 2 feet. You are made to stand up. Stand up. You are Homo erectus as a man. You stand up. The woman is leaning down on all her fours. You stand up with your 2 legs and you use your hand to hold her chest. You penetrate deep. No matter the woman, whether she's Oroboniyo or she's Lepa, you enter maximum entry. And in fact, you score that goal. You'll be Messi that night. You'll be Ronaldo tonight. Ronaldo, I can tell you. Because the way you be hitting down, you be hitting the clitoris area, and that thing makes a woman climax quickly, and you cover your ashiri secret. Ashiri means secret. Okay, you cover your secret. Another thing you can try, okay, as a man, need to understand. You see, men also need to understand yourself, okay? Usually, if you're well rested, okay, you perform better, okay? So, I always tell people, if you're going for sex, you're tired, you're going to meet your wife, you're tired, ensure you eat fruits. Have fruits at home. Have fruits at home. Or have fruits in the hustle room. Have fruits at home. Take your pineapple, orange juice, orange, very little quantity before going for the action on the mountain. Before climbing the mountain, you get some fruits. The fruits are easily absorbed into your system and send glucose into your muscles. And they make you walk faster and better. If you got no heart problems, take some Red Bull. And consistently, do not overheat. If you're going to go and perform sex with your wife, don't start eating eba, amala, akpu, plantain, panadiam. Limit all those foods. Go with just your fruits, or if you are very hungry, light diet. Be very disciplined, light diet. Then climb the mountain. Surprise the woman. Imagine you want to play football and you're already overfed. You can't perform well now. Sex is activity. Sex is power. Sex is intense. And always have in your mind that you perform. Once you believe that you can perform, you perform. I've seen a lot of couples in my session last year. This lady, she has no domestic violence history at all. She's a lovely lady. She doesn't enjoy sex with her husband. It's always pain. She had some swelling in her vagina when she was young, which was excised, taken away. Because of that, I think because of that, she thinks she has something wrong with her vagina. And whenever the husband wants to come in, into the other room, she's in pain. She is not having sex, maybe for about 6 months now. And she is affecting her relationship, their relationship. And she's suffering. So I saw this lady recently. I won't say the time. I saw her recently. And I explained to her. I examined that. There was nothing there. I reassured her nothing. I scanned that. Checked the womb. Checked the ovary. Everything was fine with the womb. Everything was fine with the ovary. Nothing obviously wrong. In fact, while I was examining her, I realized that she was very, very uncomfortable while I was putting the vaginal scan probe. So I realized that she's suffering from what we call vulvodynia, and because she's not using the organ is the vagina. The more you have sex, the better you are at sex. As men, as women, the more you have sex, the better you are at sex. If you don't do sex regularly, you'll be a poor performer in the classroom. And you don't want to carry last in this class. This class, everybody can pass. You don't want to carry last at all. See, it is nothing that your man wants that you can't give your man in bed. Okay? If he doesn't know what to do, you open the books. Open your legs, papa. Open the old sandwich. Let him put the burger inside. Open the sandwich. Make sure it's always clean. Most men will love well-shaved gorimapa vagina. So that he can see the old skin. He can see the old bare ground, bare everything. The skin is skin and shining like a newborn baby. Men love that. Skin it. Worst case scenario, you can even put some hair at the top. Make it like Gallas hairstyle. Put some hair in the middle around the clitoris and let it be even fine now. Okay? Shave everything. Shave it, everything. All the hair around the inner area. Shave it all. Men too, shave everything. Hair around your scrotum, shave it. So that when the woman can suck you, he can lick you like a lollipop. You see, once you are well shaved, there's less odor down below. Once you're well shaved, there's less irritation down below. If you can use shaving stick, if you're not allergic, you can use them. If you can use whatever they call waxing, use them. Or some cream that will make all the hair fall off, use them. Make sure that area is clean. The more you shave, the well you're shaved, the sweeter sex is for you. And the much easier it's going to be for your husband to go and perform and speak action with his mouth down below. Men want to do that. But if it's not clean, nobody wants to go and put their mouth there now. No way. But so you have to make that place clean and palatable and interesting and beautiful. All those people you watch on those stupid movies, that's what they do now. They're human beings like you now. But you need to put action. You need to put your mind and up your game and improve your game and improve your style. Okay, some women are so big ladies, they think because they are earning X amount of money, they're earning more money than their partner cannot give them instruction in the bedroom. You are losing it. The man will not give you instructions, you can be doing something else outside. Bring the man home. When you are in the bedroom with your husband, let him be the yoga. Trust me. This is not, let's forget all this sexism thing, all this women activism thing. Forget it. Let's leave that for now. Okay. Once you are in the bedroom, let your husband be your guy. Don't deny him that role. Let him be in control. Let him manhandle you. Let him violence self. I'm saying lovely one, not bad violence. You know what I mean? Please don't misquote me. Let your husband be in charge in the bedroom. Don't deny him of that right. If you are feeling your organ outside bedroom, leave that. Once you enter into the bedroom, submit. And men too, respect yourself too, so that the woman can respect you in the bedroom. The woman wants somebody that you can respect. Somebody that when they open their bum for, it's worth it. It's not something that they feel as if they've been, A woman wants to give her body to somebody that she loves. Someone that respects her. Someone that will enjoy her, someone that will respect her, and even see after sex, as a man, you must always say, tell your woman thank you. After sex in the morning, the following day, send your woman a text that thank you for yesterday. Yesterday was too good. I enjoyed yesterday. And let him know what you enjoyed yesterday. How can a person give you a body to you to enjoy and you don't thank them? You are a wicked man. So once you wake up in the morning, you're at work, you are going to work, you are in the bus, send a text to your wife. Thank you for yesterday. That style you gave me, that particular style, I enjoyed it. When you were shouting, when you were moaning, when you were showing your ringing tone, I enjoyed it. Let her know. Once she knows that she can open up to you, once she knows that what she's giving to you, you're enjoying, that you're enjoying the food she's giving to you on her plate, she'll give you more now. She'll do better. In fact, she'll be telling you where to lick on her plate. No woman wants her plate to be unlicked. You should not leave any food unchopped on your table. It's not good. You are leaving it for the dogs. Any food in your plate as a man, chop it finish. And the bones, papa. And the bones, don't even leave, even the bone, crunch it. Crunch the bones. Crunch the bones. And shatter it. Flip the head. The leg, two legs. Put it together. Put it behind her hair. So that you have access to all the old autobahn and you can drive the Mercedes from here to Kano without go slow. The two legs, flip it like a small baby, like bridge. Put it behind the head. I call it bridge style. Mm-hmm. And tell her to keep her mouth shut so that the neighbors will not hear anything. I'm born again. I'm not bad. I'm born again. I'm a shy man. No? That's why I'm wearing my face. I'm a shy person. But I have to tell you people these things today, so that people will maximize and turn things around. Most marriages have been destroyed because the man or the woman is not doing what they are supposed to do in the bedroom. Yes. Most people, they go to counseling in the church. I tell people all the time, they go for counseling in the church. Pastor, come and counsel me. We're having trouble. They're talking about money. Meanwhile, it's action. You see, if the bedroom is very, very secured and the action is happening in the bedroom, in fact, even if you have financial trouble too, two of you will cooperate together and make things happen for yourself and the financial troubles will be over. If the bedroom is functioning well, even if you have challenges, the fact that two of you are meshed together as one in the bedroom of love, you will find resources within yourself to attack your challenges and overcome them. Trust me. This I know. This I believe. Yes. So, women too should learn to appreciate their husbands too. If your husband does something that you enjoy, that you find amusing, you find so erotic, so beautiful in the bedroom, let him know. Let him know. He needs to know because he's human being too. He needs to know that he's done something good so that he can improve on that. It's called feedback. If you don't give them feedback, report card. And the things you don't like too, let him know, but say it in a very, very lovely way, in a very, very respectable way, so that he will know. Okay? And there are ways to do it. Okay? You can do it by sex, by text. Sorry, I said sex. By text. You can do it by putting a note in the dining room, or you can say it to him verbally, you can whisper it to his ears when he's going to work. Make it happen. Two of you should be friends of each other. See, why will you marry a woman that is not your friend now? Then don't marry her. Once you've married a woman, let her be open to you. You to be open to her. Once you're in the bedroom, forget anything chotto. Two of you become bamboo for yourself. Two of you chop yourself anyhow. Okay? Once you're in the bedroom, two of you, forget any manual. Anything they told you in church or not to do, forget it. Two of you are together in the Garden of Eden. Anything is possible for two of you. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. Nobody needs to know. Okay? Two of you, when two of you are in the bedroom, there's nothing called sin. Yes. When two of you are in the bedroom, two of you, as far as you are together and you agree, whatever you do, it's nobody's business. There's nothing called sin there. I say so by the grace of God. Now, I'm very hungry now. I need to go and get something to eat so that I can belly food. Tomorrow is going to be seminar for the Reliable Gender Selection. If you're here, join us at the seminar tomorrow, August 29, 9 p.m., Reliable Gender Selection. I'll be there talking about the things you must do to ensure you get what you want, sex or baby. I'll be talking about the things, important things you can do to improve your ability to select gender for baby. Be there, join me. Once again, me to you, to me, I love you all, and I want people to produce action tonight too. Okay? But don't send me texts of the things you've done. I don't want to hear what you've done to your husband or to your wife. It's not my business. But what is your business is that make her happy, you make him happy. If you are making him happy, definitely he'll make you happy. If you are making her happy, she will make you happy. As above, so below. Whatever happens, what is good for the goose, good for the gander. Enjoy each other and never dull any moment at all. Okay? Never dull any moment at all. If you don't know what style to try, try that. The woman be on all her fours today. The woman is on all her fours, okay? And putting her head down on the bed flat. And the whole bumper, the old boot is looking at you like a pot of bagoduku. You know that big pot. So the whole thing is open to you like this. She's leaning down on all her fours with all her elbows on the ground, with her face on the ground, and she's on her knees. Everything looking at you to enter to eat. Stand on all your two legs. One leg, a second leg, put your two legs down. Stand and put your hand, like second on her shoulder. And you have access to all the episode, all the trilogy, part 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. The sky is the limit. Don't dolo. Give me a report sheet. Now I've taken all the names of all the noisemakers. I'm going to tell you and I'm going to ban you from this group. See you soon. God bless you. Fill the glasses. Don't break it.